Hey, Sashan, what is going on? I'm not a fan of shorts. Don't care for shorts. One, the volume is either on or off. There's no volume control on these things. There's no rewind. There's no way to rewind. Anyway, see if I can get this thing to start from beginning.
The absolute best tabletop RPG for beginners is the one that aligns with their likes and interests. Period.
That kind of makes sense. I guess people ask me, what's the best RPG? And I say, well, what do you like? What kind of person are you? Like, first I ask them what they think a role-playing game is and start from there. If they're on the right track, if they're on the right railroad track, I ask them things like, well, what kind of books do you read? What kind of movies do you watch? What kind of music you listen to? Like, what's your favorite movie? I think 10 years ago, I would ask people, what's your favorite movie? Figure out things from there. Ask them things like, are you a fantasy person? Do you like thrillers, dramas, action, sci-fi, mystery, whodunit? Old-timey stuff, you know. Is it Jane Austen? Mary Shelley? Sherlock Holmes, that kind of stuff. Who wrote Sherlock Holmes? I can't remember. Anyway, then once they get that figured out, what kind of games have they played? What mechanics do they like? What kind of dice do they like? I don't try to force someone to play what I play, but I'm not trying to pigeonhole them into a game they would like. I'm not a salesperson. I'm not trying to sell something. I want them to figure it out. I want them to do their homework. I want them to figure out on their own what they like.
That is the best tabletop RPG for them.
Now let's say the person's they don't like violence. So then you gotta point them into RPGs that don't have violence. Scooby-Doo type RPGs. Or Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego kind of RPGs. Or Powerpuff Girls or Care Bears, Cabbage Patch. Those kinds of RPGs. More power to them if they like that kind of stuff.
Bar none. See, but the problem that we have in the tabletop RPG community and culture is this. You get some.
If they say they only like science fiction, then that cuts down the list to maybe 30 RPGs. It comes down to the setting. How far in the future? Buck Rogers' future? Flash Gordon? Contemporary? Star Trek future? Star Wars? Another galaxy far, far away, a long time ago, with humans in it? The only difference between the humans in Star Wars and the humans on Earth is the humans on Earth wear clothes that have buttons and zippers. Now, hang on, Star Wars, they have buttons and zip. They have buttons, but not zippers, right?
Somebody who's new, they're a beginner, and they show in a little bit of interest in tabletop RPG. And so you know what happens? You got people railroading them into a game.
Yeah, come in my game. Oh, you want to learn about RPGs? Well, I'm the right person for you then. You are going to love my game. I have been GMing for 30 plus years. That's how it usually goes. That's unfortunate, though. I like it when players do self-study, independent study on their own. And if they have any other questions, they can ask me or go ask someone else. Because I don't have all the answers. I don't play D&D.
That they play and not trying to find out their interest or their likes. If we want tabletop RPG recidivism, I guess, to be low, you have to switch your mindset. Leech, y'all know I talk about mindset constantly on this channel. You have to switch your mindset and go from one to trying to serve you to trying to serve them. To actually...
I'm not a facilitator. I'm not trying to entertain my players. I'm not trying to, I'm not babysitting. I don't like to babysit. I'm not a youth center counselor. I don't have programs for, my 6-to-6 program kids. I figure these are grown-up people. They're just curious about role-playing. So I point them in certain directions. Sometimes I hear back from them. Sometimes I don't hear from them again, which is fine. You know, let's say if there's only 58 role players on planet Earth, let's say. They're most likely gonna just go with, they'll find somebody who just pushes D&D 5e because that's the latest thing. Everyone plays it. That's what everyone wants to play. Apparently it was on a TV show. AD&D or maybe Basic or Expert was on a TV show. People see Critical Role and they see the D&D 5. Oh my goodness, D&D. Okay. That must be the thing then. It's like when someone says, I want to see a movie. I've never seen a movie before. What's a good movie to see? Oh, I can tell them who my favorite director is. But they haven't seen a movie before, so they don't even... They wouldn't know what I'm even comparing with or talking about. And they'll end up just going into any triple triplex cinema with 70 millimeter and... They'll pick the movie that has the biggest theater. You know, do they like drama, dramedy, comedy, thriller, action, slow burn, jump scare? You know, these are things people have to figure out when they want to see the best movie. The first movie they want to see in life they want it to be the best movie there is. Some would say, actually, it's Citizen Kane. I have 10 top favorite movies, and that list can change on a, you know, decade by decade. That top 10 list of favorite films could change. There's no order. It's a random top 10 order, but they're always in the top 10.
Actually try to put them in the spotlight and really find out what it is that they are interested in.
Okay, I'm not going to use psychotherapy to find out what RPG a person likes. Well, let's run through a few sessions with you and see which ones ring your bell.